Good morning, children. We start our lesson. Okay, pond as a habitat. Okay, see here. We can see the several organisms are present in the pond. Okay, we can see the frog. Yes, we can see the frog, fishes, egg of the fish, frog. Okay, egg of the frogs and the grasses, pistia, lotus. Everything they are present in the water. Animals and the plants also present in the water. See here. To study them more closely, we need to see the different regions in the pond. So, in the pond, we can have the different regions. So, we can divide into four parts: pond surface, surface. Okay, pond surface, mid water, pond margin, and bottom of the pond. So, we can discuss one by one. See here, which animal and plants do you think live on the surface of the pond? Okay, on the surface of the pond, what type of animals are living? What type of animals are living? And also we can see what type of animals are living in the mid of the water and the margins of the pond and the bottom of the pond. Which animal and plant do you think live in the mid water? In the mid water, what type of animal and the plants are living inside the pond? We have to know that. See now. Which animal and plants do you think would live in the pond margins? And okay, we have to see which type of animal and the plants are living in the four stages: in the pond surface, in the mid water, in the pond margin, and bottom of the pond. Okay. See here, in the pond, we find the different organisms living in different regions. This is due to the some condition like our. Okay, why they are living in the different regions? Why? What is the reason? Some of the organisms are living on the surface, some of the organisms are living at the middle of the water, and some of the organisms are living on the margins and the bottom of the pond. Why they are? So, why they are living in the different places means because they they require the availability of the food. Due to the availability of food, okay, availability of the food and also different amount of food, air also depends upon the why they are living at the different places means due to the availability of the food and the air and light. Some require the very less light, some require the more light. Like this, they can live in the different regions, levels. Okay, we can say different levels, we can say. Okay, why they are living in the different, like this. Okay, we can see here, we find organism like dragonfly. Okay, in the first, see here, I am taking here, see here, we find organism like dragonfly, mayfly and the kingfisher living above the surface. It is the surface, okay, pond surface. And you can see here, that dragonflies are living above the surface, pond surface. That the dragonfly, kingfisher, they get from where they get the food, they get food from the surface of the pond. Have you seen the kingfisher? It eats only the fishes. Okay? And living above the surface. That is above the pond and resting over a bamboo pole or a stick jutting out of the surface of the pond. So they are this dragonfly, mayfly or the kingfisher, they live above the surface of the water. So they get the food from the surface of the water, and when they get the food, they will rest on the bamboos or the on the trees. Okay, and then they get food from the surface. Okay, this animal, from where they are getting the food? From the surface of the pond. Organism like snail, building beetle and the pond skater live on the surface. So on the surface, what type of organisms are living? We can see the pond skater. Pond skater are living on the surface. See here, pond skater is
This is the pond skater. You can see in the page number
63. You can see some of the insects. Okay. Pond skater, snail. Okay. And drilling beetle. All these are living on the surface of the pond. By the talabe, and also we can see the eggs of fish and the frog, and also the larva. Larva also present on the surface of the pond. Okay. The larva of the mayfly and the dragonfly also live on the surface. Okay. This dragonfly and the mayfly, they lay the eggs on the surface of the water. Dragonfly and the mayfly will lay the eggs on the surface of the water, and the larvae also present on this surface. Plants like this, they are floats on the surface completely, while those like the lotus have the roots going deep under. So, pistia is a flower. See here, pistia is.
See here, it is a pistia. You can see. It is a pistia. Can you see this? Yeah.
Pistia, it's also live on the surface of the water, and the lotus also present on the surface of the water, and the roots will be at the bottom of the pond. Okay. See here, plants like pistia grows on the surface. Okay, it will float. Okay, the pistia, the plant. Okay, they doesn't have the. Okay, then the roots doesn't go under the water. Okay, it doesn't go. Under the water, doesn't go. It floats on the water. It can float on the water. They are very small, and plants like pistia grows on the surface completely, while those like the lotus have the roots going under the deep. For the lotus, you can see the lotus veins on the surface of the water. Yes, and the where the roots, have you seen the roots? No, it is under the water. And the leaves also on the surface only. You can see the on the surface only the leaves. On the surface organism are easily eaten by us. Okay, so the organisms which are present on the surface of the water, the other animals which are above the surface, they can easily eaten by the other organism. They are eaten by other organism. So the protection also very less on the surface of the water. Protection also very less. They can't save themselves. They are eaten by the other organism. And in the mid of the water, we can see the frog also we can see, fish, and tortoise also we can see the tortoise. Okay, you can see the tortoise also. We can also the great water boatman. See the page number 63, you can see here, the some of the organism here. Great water boatman, leech, mosquito, larvae are found in the mid water. So, in the mid water also you can see the what type of great water boatman, leech, in the middle of the leech you can see, and also you can see the mosquitoes, larvae in the mid of the water. These are the organisms which live in the mid of the water. Pond margins. Okay, it is the margins. We can say it is the margin. Pond margin. In the pond margin, you can see the several grasses also. You see the sides of the ponds. You can see the most of the plant will grow. Okay, mostly the grasses. You can see the mostly the grasses, and the snail also present. Yes, we can see the snail, frog. You can see the frogs at the. Okay, the frog can live in the water as well as on the land also. Frog, and we can see the crabs. Crabs also we can see. Okay, and also in the margins, what type of again we can see. We can see the grasses, snail, frog and crabs. And some more example is, you can give. What are the some more example you can, sometimes we can see them on the margins. Other animals also will be present. What type of leech also present? Okay, leech also present at the margins, and the snail also presents. Okay, fish lay. Okay, fish usually lay eggs here. So, and we can see on the margins the crane also present. They stand at the land and they can catch the fishes, and also and at the bottom of this, it is the bottom. You can see the hydrilla. Hydrilla. See in the page number 63, my hydrilla is there. You can see the hydrilla. Okay, hydrilla. You can see and what type of, and also we can see the animals like flatworms. Flatworms. Balsinaria, Naria, etc. We can see so many, and also the dead bodies of animals and the plants. Okay, we can see in this, and in this light is okay. Here we can see the light is very minimum, very less light we will get at the bottom, and where we get the more light at the surface of the pond. Okay. We can get here very less light, sunlight. Light is minimum, but food is in the form of dead and decaying matter is plenty. So we can find the more amount of food at the bottom of the pond. We can get the more plenty of food. Plenty of food we are available in the bottom of the pond. Okay. So these are the animals and the plants which lives on the pond. Organism that lives in the different levels of the pond. Try to answer the following question on the basis of what you have read. Name some organism in the pond that you can stay in different regions in the same pond. The frog can live at the surface also, it can live at the mid of the and the margin also it can live. What makes them stay in different regions? Okay, what is the reason they are living at the different regions? They can get the food. Okay, availability of food is good. Okay, the availability of the food also plenty in the different regions, and can different places in the pond also call the habitat years. So different places, the pond surface or the mid water, or these are the habitat. We can say these are also a habitat. Some of the organisms live on the surfaces, some of the organisms can live on the mid water, and some of the animals can live at the bottom also. So it is also called as the habitat. Yes, so we can see some of the organisms also living on the margins. So it is also the habitat for this organism. Okay. And then, is there any animal with legs in the pond? Yes. With the legs, which one has the legs? The crane has the legs. Yes or no? They have the legs. And do all animals in the pond have the tail? No. All the animals have the tail in this? No. The frog has a tail? No. When it is in the tadpole, they have the tail. After when they become the adult, they doesn't have the tail. So all the animals which are living in the pond, they doesn't have the tail. Do all animals in the pond swim? Yes. All the animals, only the which one can swim, the crane cannot swim in the water. And remaining, the dragonfly cannot swim in the water. Yes, they can swim? No. They can't? No. So, some of the animals cannot swim in the water. Most of the animals can, like fish, frog, crab, they can swim in the water. What are the animals that share the surface of the pond as habitat? So, we can say, most of the animals will share the ponds, okay, surfaces. Most of the animals, they can live on the surfaces. Are leaves of plants growing in the pond similar? What is the difference between the leaves of the plant growing at the bottom of the hydrilla? So what is the differences? Okay, you have to find out the what are the differences. Present on the surfaces and the at the bottom of the water. What is the differences between these two. Can you give this answer for me? So in this, it doesn't have the stomata. They have the stomata. They have the stomata on the upper side of the leaf. But in the bottom of the plant, which are present in the bottom of the palm, they doesn't have the stomata. They doesn't have the stomata. They cannot have the stomata. Okay. And on the surface of this, they have the some wax-like substance. That's why they are not spoiled. Okay. In all ponds, we can see both plants and animals. Yes, we can see the plants and animals in the water. The plants that we see in water are called aquatic plants. So the plants which we are able to see in the water, they are called aquatic plants, which grow in the water. The plants which are grown in the water are known as the aquatic plants. The animals which live in the water are called aquatic animals. Plants and aquatic animals. Animals which are living in the water are called aquatic animals, and the plants which grow in the aquatic in the water is known as aquatic plants. Okay, so we have completed our pond as a habitat. The next class I will explain about the tree as a habitat. Thank you.